Assalamu alaikum students. Today I am going to tell you about the class boundary. How can you create a class boundary if the group data is given, if the class interval is given, how can you make how can you create the class boundary? Class boundary means if the data is not, if the group data is not in overlapping form, the classes are not overlapping. So if you want to make it overlap, so we need to create a class boundary which overlap the data. The first step is, when we are going to create a class boundary, subtract the first upper limit from the second lower limit and dividing the difference by 2, and subtract this value from all of the lower class limit and add the value to all the upper class limit. And now if the data is in group form, so the example I will show you. This is an example. The grades, these are the grades of the students, the marks of the students: 20 till 29, 30 till 39, 40 till 49, 52, 59, 62, 69. The data is in group form or a continuous group data is given. If you want to make a class boundary, so what will we do? For this, we just take the upper limit of the first class and the lower limit of the second class and subtract these two limits, means 30 minus 29. The difference between these two limits is equals to 1. Now you can see and observe. 30 minus 29 equals to 1. And now divide 1 by 2. And divide the difference by 2. So 1 divided by 2 is equals to 0.5. If we want to make it an overlapping class, because these data is in continued form, but the classes are non-overlapping class. Non-overlapping means the upper limit is ended at the 29, then lower limit, the second class lower limit is start from the new value, which is 30. That data is in continual form, but the classes are non-overlapping classes. If we want to make the classes overlapping classes, so we have to subtract 0.5 from the lower limit of each class and add 0.5 to upper limit of each class. We get a overlapping class limits. So you can check, if subtract 0.5 from 20, it become 19.5. 0.5 subtract 30, it become 29.5. Now add 0.5 to 29, it become 29. At 39 plus 0.5, it becomes 39.5. Now you can check your data, these classes are overlapping, because the first class start from 19.5 and end up on 29.5, and the new class will start from 29.5, which is the upper limit of the first class, and the new and the second limit of the and the ad will share complete. So you can check. Okay, this is the our example. Okay, you can just review your example. We can make class boundary from subtracting 0.5 to the from the lower limit and add 0.5 to the upper limit of the class. We can get a overlapping class interval. The data is in this type of data is in continued form. This is a continuous group data, but the classes are non-overlapping class. So if you want to make the overlapping class limits, so we just subtract 0.5 from the lower limit and add 0.5 to the upper limit. So we can get a overlapping class interval. Thank you so much. Maybe it will be helpful for you. So when you are going to draw the histogram, you can use these class boundary for the overlapping class interval. Thank you so much.